Welcome back, guys, to another episode of Factorio Lazy Bastard. Let's play. So, yeah, in the last episode, we started with the Blue Science production. So now let's just finish it, I'd say. So, we said that we need 24 assembly machines here, doing Blue Science, basically. Okay, we could just do two things in the middle, and then let's just do this height here as an output belt. So first assemble here, then just like that. I'm just going to build one slice again so we can just copy it again. Okay, now some of these guys and yeah, then some set recipes basically, and that's it. Okay. So that's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yeah, I'm not too sure because we are getting too close over here. I would say let's get a deconstruction planner. So oh, we already have one. Let's count here. So those are 16. Yeah, it would be cool to have like 12 on either side. So if we get rid of four more, that should leave us exactly with 12. Okay, so now we can copy that one over. But before I do that, I wanna bring in all the power poles, so we can also copy them over. Okay, just like that, and let's also connect it over here, maybe also over there. And now we can copy this thing to here. Yeah, we are going to join it anyways in just one belt, so it doesn't matter if we do it like this here. Okay. Now we also need our red science packs, or red circuits, I mean. Duh. Yeah, we will need to. Yeah, I wanna let actually a little bit space in here so we can split and distribute them a little bit better. Okay, just building over the thing here. So yeah, it's. The bus isn't built that far yet. That's a bit of a pain here, actually. Yeah, there are still quite a few belts missing in there, but I think this will just take a little bit of time and then it's done. Stop like that, okay. Yeah, then an underground D. And then we can join it into here. Similarly over here, we can connect this in like that, and then we can hook this in as well. Sweet, sweet, sweet. So now we should have everything here, basically. Okay, so now we only need to merge it together, basically. Yeah, just like that, and then just like that. I mean, I'm using a splitter right here, but I think I could just also bring them directly and correct that and connect them directly. It would probably also be possible, but I like to do it with a splitter, so I'm doing it with a splitter. Damn it. Okay, so now we also have our blue science automated. I know it's a bit of a bold claim here, looking at how everything's looking like, but yeah. I do want to connect it in up here though. So let's do that. Okay, we can also use the old bells here, doesn't really matter. Okay, so yeah, now we only need to bring in some bells here everywhere. I will just do that by hand. Okay, maybe we should have expanded the bus with the normal bells. But I mean, oh no, that has to connect actually. Okay. Now I will do the same thing just with the red circuits here. And I'm also sure that I also know that the red circuits are definitely not going to be enough. Yeah, it's not even going to be close, that's for sure. But yeah, that's now the next thing that we could fix. Okay, so now it's all also bright. Cool. We could also bring in some lamps over here, I suppose. Or, well, we couldn't. Damn it. Okay, so when will the first... oh yeah, here are actually the first bits of blue signs. So let's also connect all of that. And now I'm out of the red bells myself, damn it. Okay. Yeah, but now we could kick off some blue signs stuff here. Yeah, definitely robot working space speed here, that's for sure. Because those guys are just way too slow. Plus 35%, damn, that's a lot, actually. Yeah, but I'm already liking how they fly around here. And they do look pretty nice in 0.16. I think I never really looked at them that closely in 0.16, but they definitely do look really, really, really sweet. Okay. Yeah, let's pick up some stuff here that they want to deliver to me. Thank you. Okay, now we do have quite some time left in this episode, actually. Let's also get rid of some more things here, maybe. Oh, yeah, I do want to place the radar down here. Over here somewhere. Yeah, there's damn pipes everywhere, just stick in them and then you can't move anymore. It's a bit of a problem, but yeah. Now we have everything covered in here as well. So now another nice thing is that our construction robots theoretically could repair stuff because we also have the repair packs in our system. Yeah, so I do want to connect actually also out of here, so just in case that aliens attack, that our robots could actually like reach this all and repair it. Okay, we do need more gears, and for that we probably would need more iron. Yes, we do. We definitely do not have enough iron anymore. Oh well, yeah, but it seems like our biggest problem still is the belt speed here. I mean, yeah, it's just a couple of furnaces not working, but it would definitely make at least a small difference if we would have everything set up here with red belts. But we kinda do not have enough red belts right now, so yeah, that's also an issue. Okay. What do I want to do next? One thing actually, and that is the modular armor. I definitely do wanna have one, because I think that would be pretty cool. Yeah, we don't have much stuff that we could make with it though, or put in it. So and I would have enough stuff, but obviously I just have to remember to just put it into an assembly machine here and not to craft it by hand. That's the wrong one. I want to go to this one. And I only want to make one. Okay, so now we have to wait a bit. Okay, like how long can it take, please? Quicker, thank you. Okay, so now actually, yeah, we do get an additional row of inventory space with them, so that's pretty sweet. So the modular armor basically okay, something crashed here. I was able to read something with creative mode. So let's just disable that one mod and hope that we can get back into the game without, I mean, it didn't save, obviously. Oh no. Why? Yeah, we don't have any creative mode mod stuff anymore. Yeah, but it doesn't look like we lost a lot of progress here. Yeah, but we have to collect our stuff again. Yeah. Okay, and some steel plates. I mean, luckily that didn't cost us too much time now. Oh, and I guess that our thing up here is back again. I thought I disabled that, but seemed like that was really a problem with the creative mode mod, which I obviously don't need here anyways. I just had it still enabled because I was doing some building for tutorials and stuff, and yeah, for that you kind of want to have a creative mode mod. So yeah, I mean, sure, if your base is big enough, then that's also your creative mode. But yeah, let's just save the game here real quick. Okay, now we can get back into it, hopefully. Yeah, it didn't crash. Nice. So we now have an array of 5x5 where we can put in modules, because just like that right now it doesn't do anything basically. So we need to get energy and we can put things in there. We can't do much stuff right now though. I really would like to get an exoskeleton working or something. I mean, also like force fields, but I think they are energy shields, but they require military science. So yeah, now we have that. Now basically we are less protected than we were before, but yeah, we need solar panels now. I'm not too sure if that was too good of an idea, to be honest. Yeah, let's just get a bunch of copper and steel going. Luckily we have everything nearby. Because I need some solar panels now, basically. Okay. Yeah. At least it gives us 10 slots inventory space extra, but I think other than that, it wouldn't help us now too much because, yeah, we should go for power armor basically. Portable fusion reactor, that's also definitely something that's necessary. Actually, power armor is fairly cheap from the research, but we do need a processing unit for that one, which we also can't make yet. So yeah, this will take some time with the solar panels, I think. So we should probably worry now about our production stuff down here. So how does it look like right here? Okay. Yeah, it definitely doesn't look that good. Because there are lots of belts still missing. But we can also definitely tell that our red circuit production is far, far from ideal. Or far from even being close to enough. Yeah, I mean, that was just quickly thrown together thing. We should probably. No, we don't even need to upgrade it because we are missing plastics. And plastics are currently not having enough. Oh, yeah, our light oil is full. Oh, we need a tank. I should say we need a storage tank. Because now our light oil output is full, and that means that we can't make any stuff anymore. Okay. Let me actually remove this guy. Okay. So that should hopefully work now again for a little while at least. You also need. Okay, here we go. Yeah, heavy oil is probably going to have the same problem here soon. Okay, but now that's all working, we are getting new advanced circuits now, basically. This all is also still working. Yeah, like we should probably try to get them into a row port here somehow. Okay. And let's underground that, and then we could use this robot port right here for our construction robots, and then we could use this robot port right here for our logistic robots. I think that is an awesome idea. Oh, okay. So now, basically, what's happening is that the robots get directly put into RoboPort, so they are directly available in our system. So, yeah, I think now is a good time to also do something about our power production. We are getting definitely close to aliens over here. And we are absolutely not protected over here from aliens, so that's a pretty bad thing. We also don't have any advanced piercing round magazines. Can we make lasers? I really would want to make some laser turrets. But we can't. That's sad. Yeah, they do need military science packs. So I think military science packs should be the very next thing to worry about now. Okay, we definitely also do need more space on our bus down here, that's for sure. But we don't have the resources now to do that, which is kind of a problem. So we don't have. Yeah, we do have some fast transit belts again. So So let's just use them to try and speed up our iron production over here, basically. Okay. Oh yeah, these things. Also went missing. Okay, and now we can upgrade these. We can also split that, so the both lanes are equally distributed again. Yeah, so now the one side completely works. And then it should get merged over here. So now at least it's a fast output directly here. Yeah, but that's all working very slowly. Yeah, this guy does need to produce quite some assembly machines now. Okay. Yeah, we still don't have any more fast transport belts. That's an issue, definitely. But yeah, it's also an issue that we have to care about in the next episode, because now we are basically done with this one. So thank you for watching. See you all in the next one. Have a great day. Bye bye.